Hello and welcome to this edition of Market Guru. Joining me today is Rasesh Shah, Chairman and CEO, Edelweiss Group. Thanks very much, Rasesh. It's always a pleasure talking to you. When we last spoke, that was 31st of July. I remember at least five times in that interview, you said you were very hopeful of the next two quarters. You talked about the animal spirits getting unleashed in the next couple of quarters. You talked about earnings getting better. We've done 2 months of that, and it's been a fairly exciting 2 months. How are you looking at things right now? How's your mood?
I think overall, as we have always said, the current year from April onwards, there has been significant improvement on almost all the economic parameters, including the current account gap, inflation, interest rates came down in April when RBI cut rates, as well as I think the global situation has improved. So I think from both sentiment and liquidity point of view, we are fairly good, especially in the last few weeks, as the global liquidity scenario has improved significantly. And along with obviously the issue of what we used to call policy paralysis and the government inaction, even that has gone away. So I think things look fairly good, though I think it will take another few quarters for earnings growth to come back, for economic growth to go above 6% again. And I do feel that India will go closer to 7%. It looks unlikely how we will go above 7% given the inflation issues and all we have. But I think what we were all fearing of the GDP growth rate being closer to 5% has gone away. And I think we should be in 6+ region again now.
It's interesting you said that sentiment and liquidity-wise, things have really given or gotten a leg up. But are you saying on the ground, the picture still has a long way to go to play out?
Yeah, I think things have started improving. As I said, I think interest rates came down in April. Now we are hoping that interest rates will come back again a little bit down in October after the RBI policy. So I think we need to see fundamental improvement, though there has been a slight uptick in the last 5-6 months. For a significant improvement, I think it will take another 2-3 quarters. But we are seeing that corporates are also now starting to feel optimistic again. We'll start seeing credit growth maybe another 3-4 months from now. I think the investment story, which is still a big question mark in India, should hopefully also get started, because we are seeing, I think, with all this FDI coming in and all over the next couple of quarters. So what we have seen is the fundamental improvement. The structural improvement is always a few quarters after this, but it all starts with sentiment and liquidity. So good thing is that both sentiment and liquidity are fairly positive, and they will fuel into the earnings and the fundamental story now.
Are you being a bit too optimistic in feeling, Rasesh, that in two quarters we will move towards the investment cycle actually kicking off? I know last time you told me that unfortunately consumption without an investment story on the other side will eventually be inflationary. You also made the point that we need to see the investment side of the story also kicking in to support the consumption story. Do you believe that in two quarters, because of these announcements which we've seen, things will start turning around?
I think it will start. I think the corporates that we speak to, a lot of them are considering, investing again in India. It won't happen, very quickly. But I think even the FDI, the opening up and all, will start seeing a little bit of, investment now happening on the ground, because a lot of this FDI also has supply chain requirement. So all of that should see a little bit of uptick in the investment horizon. I think when we talk to banks and also they feel that the credit uptake will start to happen maybe after in the fourth quarter onwards. So it won't be a significant improvement. And as I said, it's hard to see our GDP growth going above 7% as of now. But where we were being scared that it will be closer to 5%, I think going above 6 and getting closer to 7 itself is a big relief and a very good cause for optimism.
When we spoke last, Rasesh, you were of the view that we'll end FY13 with about an 8 to 10% kind of an earnings growth. You said if you exclude banks, we would probably end at about 13 to 14%. Are you still sticking with that view?
Yeah, I think it will be around that. And I think even the banks will have, on the operating side, fairly good earnings growth. But I think it's going to be another quarter of, NPA cleanup and all that should go on. So that will keep their earnings down. But I think if you look at excluding banks, 14 to 15% corporate earnings growth still seems on the cards.
Are you more optimistic as regards banks? I know we discussed it quite extensively last time, and you had raised the flag on the fact that NPAs was a concern, although you did mention that several bank chairmen are looking at cleaning up quite effectively. Do you see that process playing out? Are things better in that space today than they were when we last spoke?
Yeah. See, I think it's always good to clean up your NPA and the asset quality issues, when the going is good. So I think now if there is credit growth going to start happening fourth quarter onwards, I think if interest rates come down post-October, it will give some room to, just expediting the cleanup and the restructuring and all the restructuring of loans that is going on. So I think maybe another quarter of cleanup and the pain is still there, but I think we will get towards the end. And at the end of the day, growth is usually the best cleansner for all this. So once growth comes back, even a little bit of growth, if I think currently credit growth is around 16%, if it goes back to 18 or 20%, I think it will help a lot of the cleanup along the way.
How are valuations looking to you at this point of time, Rashesh? We have seen a bit of a rally, but billions continue to get poured in into this market. What's really going on?
I think overall, we have fairly valued. What had happened is the valuation also was taking into account all the gloom, doom and all the bad news which was getting priced in. If you remember when we spoke last time, the whole issue is how much of the bad news has got priced in, and thanks to, I think, media, international India and Indian media, I think all the bad news was highlighted, the investors got a chance to price it in. So I think all the bad news is already priced in, maybe some of the good news have got priced in, but I think people are still waiting and watching. We do feel international investors are still fairly underweight on India. Even a lot of Indian investors have reduced their allocations to equities. Even the insurance companies and others who have increased allocation to fixed income and have reduced it to equities over the last couple of years will start realigning that. So I think there is a fair amount of appetite, cash flow that will come into the equity markets. And so things look fairly good and stable as of now. But again, no cause for unbridled optimism, but I think cautious optimism, and things have started to the uptick has started.
A lot of brokerages, Rashesh, are already talking 20,000, 21,000. Am I hearing you say that this is not a time to get euphoric?
Yeah, I think, as I said, ultimately the structural improvement, the fundamental improvement has to also come through, and it should be, very clearly evident also, which will take a few quarters from now. But it's a good start, and I think the optimism has come back. This entire feeling that India was being written off, that India was, completely lost the plot, has gone away. I think people are saying India will not go away. There are ways India can self-correct, India can, understand the growth crisis that we have and start taking action. And as I said, once we go above 6% growth and get closer to 7%, I think things will start improving. So we need to see that fundamental improvement coming through. So it is a good time to be optimistic, not be very pessimistic about India as we were maybe a few quarters ago, but also not yet, I think, room for unbridled optimism and saying, we'll hit new highs and all. I think we need to see the next two quarters are very crucial. We need to see interest rates coming down. We need to see credit growth going up. I think I would say these two are the most important things to watch, obviously along with global, global scenario, and we are hoping that for the next 5-6 months, global scenario on both the European front and the oil front is fairly stable.
We've heard the finance minister going on record multiple times, Rashesh, to see that you can expect some capital market related reforms. Of course, we've seen that equity scheme being notified. What are the other one or two things that you would expect to happen on that front? Because you've talked about the rate cut bit as one of the next triggers. You've talked about a pickup in loan growth, which I'm presuming you're linking it to that would be a sign of investments. But other than these two, especially with regard to the markets, what are the two or three things that you would be very keen to see?
I think everybody understood that now, we need to get the financial savings coming back into the market, because household savings in India have still been robust. But in the last year or two, a lot of the household savings have been going into real estate and gold. And there is a need to create incentive for households to invest in financial assets because they are the most productive from an economic growth point of view. So I think things like realigning STT, maybe on the capital gains, I think, the GAR report that is going to come out is going to speak about that. So So I think STT on the capital gains front is I think an area that we do expect some amount of reforms to help investments into equity markets become a lot more easier. I think some stuff on the bond market side to revive the bond markets, because ultimately if you really want to channelize capital into projects for the long term, usually the bond market is a good way. So I think we are expecting some initiatives on the bond market front also.
What is the mood among retail investors, Rashesh? You run a retail franchise as well. Are you seeing some kind of interest coming back from retail investors after what we've seen last 3 weeks, 1 month?
I think a little bit. I think people are starting to get interested. They are starting to speak about equities again, and they are looking at all options, including indirect investments through insurance companies and the mutual funds, as well as investing on their own. I think a lot of retail investors will really flock to the market on their own when IPOs and all start coming in, which also we think will be 3 to 6 months from now. So I think retail investors are starting to get interested again. I don't think we have seen a huge amount of flows coming from retail investors. From investors, I think if flows have come, I think HNI investors have come back. Quite a few HNIs who are investing into banks and into bonds and all have started reallocating some of that capital away from the fixed income instruments into the equity markets again.
How would you really relook at the portfolio now, Rashesh? Would you continue to be defensive, as we've seen most of the people being, but we've seen a lot of people trying to take some aggressive contrarian calls? What would your portfolio stance be with that 100 rupees, what you'd be doing right now?
I think the idea is obviously the FMCG and pharma sector, which are good places to hide, have been fairly valued by now, and there are others which are undervalued. So our strategy is to go into sectors which were stressed, but invest into companies in those sectors which are not stressed. So there are quite a few sectors, like we spoke about banks, which for the last year and a half have underperformed the market significantly. But there are in the public sector banks, in the private sector banks category, they are good banks which are not stressed, but this sector as a whole was, everybody was going underweight on. So there are good opportunities in that. The same thing is true with infrastructure. There are some good quality infra companies which are all getting hammered in the last year and a half because the issues with the sector as a whole. So I think a slightly stressed sector, but good companies within the sector is where we do feel there is a good risk reward opportunities for investors.
What is your view on the rupee now? Is the worst over? Are we going to continue to see it strengthen?
I think on almost all the fronts, if you see global liquidity as well as the current account gap and the flows and all that, we do feel that the rupee will eventually should stabilize between 50 to 52. We hope it should not go above 50, in the sense appreciate above 50, because then our export sector will start getting hurt again and all. And our internal view is that any value for rupee under 50, it will be overvalued. And I think 52 and above that will be undervalued. So if the rupee stabilizes between 50 and 52, from both imports and exports point of view, I think we are on reasonable ground. So we do think the rupee will stabilize there.
All right, Rashesh, always a pleasure talking to you. Thank you very much for joining us and talking to our viewers here on Bloomberg TV India.